Hi there, and welcome to my review of In Fabric. So In Fabric is the latest film by Peter Strickland, who's one of the greatest genre directors working in Britain at the moment, making loads of films that are homages to like giallo cinema and old Euro horror. And he's best known for making Barbarian Sound Studio and The Duke of Burgundy. In Fabric, as his new film, is just profoundly weird and really out there. And it's a really good horror comedy. I don't quite know which side of that it's more, but it's certainly both enjoyable and clearly a horror film and a lot of its genre touches. So from the opening seconds of this film, I knew I would love it. It opened up and I just instantly was like, this is the exact sort of thing I like to see. And it is just that. It is just really weird and strange and beguiling and bizarre and fucking out there. In Fabric follows a dress. And basically whoever wears the dress has bad luck happened to them, and in most cases, not a happy ending, shall we say. So the film basically just follows people who have the dress, and for that premise alone, it sounds pretty nuts, and that pretty much sets the tone of the film. It is indeed kind of nuts. So the film is just so strange. The world it's set in is completely bizarre. It's a sort of never world. It's not our world. It's not any other world. It might be set in the 1950s, kind of, but it also feels kind of modern. It's a completely out there setting, to say the least, and it has well-known comedy actors playing key roles, and it certainly is really funny in the way the world is executed. The world is totally illogical, and that's kind of the strength of the film, is that it makes no sense. It is a complete world of illogic. It doesn't even attempt to make sense, and that's kind of what you enjoy about it. You get into it, you go, this is weird and it's strange and it's really, really good. The film basically has two stories. It has a story which takes like the first hour and a bit, and then another story takes the second half, and although it is technically all connected, they basically function as very separate storylines. And in fact, I think the first story is the better of the two. I think the first story starts off as a bit strange. It takes a while to get going, but then once it kicks in, it's really amazing. It's perfectly brilliant in its own little strange way, and it has its own funny moments, and it also has some really interesting stuff. The second half, although still really, really solid, probably doesn't match the first half, and I think that's probably because the second half of the first story is really fantastic, so the second story just can't really compete, and so it does kind of feel like a bit of a letdown. I think it kind of picks up, but then the ending of the film is a complete disappointment. Peter Strickland seems to get lost in the latter half of this film, just like he did with The Duke of Burgundy, another film which I really liked, but once again sort of fell apart towards the end. And I feel like Peter Strickland's films have this issue where he has a really great idea, a really great genre idea, and then he ends up losing it along the way. So the ending here is probably the weakest part of the film. But that said, I still love the entire thing. There's some interesting sex stuff in this film as well, if you really want to get into that. The first half is quite kinky at times. It certainly has elements of its sex which are graphic and strange, and certainly elements which are provocative. The second half is kind of interesting in that it basically has no sensuality, and it basically has no intimacy. It's basically just this strange sort of sexless existence. I mean, there is sex in it, but it so lacks passion as to be its own kind of different niche. It's a weird collection of stuff, the way sex is used in this film. And In Fabric as a whole is just a weird collection of stuff. It doesn't make a lick of sense at all. And the characters are caricaturist, to say the least. They're not in any way real, but that only heightens the comedy. I mean, the comedy here is quite often just because the film's ridiculousness at face value is played seriously, but also the comedy comes from bits that are obviously jokes. The characters say stuff which are clearly meant to be gags and witty, and so it certainly is a comedy, and it certainly is funny. I certainly know that people in my screening thought it was hilarious, and I too thought it was a really funny film. So whilst I think In Fabric has a couple of flaws here and there, there's no question to me this is one of the most fun films I've seen in a while, and I think it's an absolutely great ride of a film. I think it's really fascinating, a really great piece of genre cinema, and just really effective. So I think In Fabric is a great film, and I think it's gonna be seen by many and enjoyed by most. So that's what I think, and I'd love to hear your thoughts on In Fabric if you've seen it, so please leave me a comment. If you'd like this review, please give it a like. If you want to read more of my reviews, you're welcome to follow me on Letterboxd or Twitter. If you want to hear more of my reviews, you're welcome to subscribe. Thank you for watching, and In Fabric, it's a great film.